If happiness isn't the goal, then what is? It's a question that some people find perplexing because they assume that happiness should always be what we strive for. This is incorrect for two reasons. If it were the goal, we'd most likely take the easy ride and miss out on anything that might challenge us and thereby help us to grow and learn. Another reason is that we risk putting happiness on some far-off horizon to chase when it's better for our well-being to cherish what we have at this moment. As the Greek philosopher Aristotle said, happiness depends on ourselves. In this Ride Bus Life Coaching video, I'm going to discuss a leading psychologist model for understanding what really contributes to our happiness and well-being. I'll be back after the opening titles. In the meantime, are you on the right bus? And welcome back. Here we are talking all about personal development, your personal development. My name is Mervin Straughan, creator of the Three Journeys Life Coaching System, and I'm the author of the Pocket Self-Help Guide, Imagine Life as Three Bus Journeys. Today we're looking at the factors that contribute to happiness and how we can manage them. Sometimes when asked what makes people happy or makes them feel successful, we'll turn to material things that we associate with success and show we have plenty of them. This often comes about through negative conditioning and the desire to avoid certain circumstances. In other words, we want to avoid a lack of money, so we ask for lots of it. We want to avoid struggle, and we want to avoid growing old without someone to love us. Happiness isn't the goal. That's because it's a byproduct. It's what happens when we achieve balance across our lives. So achieving balance is the goal. American psychologist Martin Seligman, a leader in the field of positive psychology, has given us the PERMA, P-E-R-M-A model to help us understand and achieve balance. The model identifies the five areas that contribute to our well-being. PERMA stands for positive emotions, engagement, relationships, meaning, and accomplishment. Let's look at each of these in more detail. Positive emotions. Here we're talking about feeling positive and recognizing that we have control over our lives. We're optimistic about the future, we're fully aware of the present, and we take a positive view of our past. Now, having a positive view of a particularly challenging past might require us to cultivate an attitude of gratitude and forgiveness. Engagement. This is where we're fully immersed in what we're doing. Remember the time when you've been involved in your favorite hobbies and time has simply flown by? This state of being absorbed is often referred to as being in a state of flow. Being engaged raises our well-being and calms us. Relationships. By nature, we're social animals with brains that are hardwired to make connections with others and to depend on others. Parents, siblings, friends, colleagues, neighbors, and so on. Establishing strong connection makes us feel safe and valued. Meaning. This is about feeling part of something bigger than simply pursuing something for personal gain. It's about having a strong sense of purpose, knowing why we're here and what we can do to help society. And finally, accomplishment. We can develop an immense satisfaction from setting and achieving goals because if they're the right ones, we'll grow and learn, and they'll increase how we feel about our ability and sense of control over our lives. Even achieving modest goals can make us feel good, strengthening our self-belief. As mentioned earlier, Seligman is a pioneer of positive psychology, and it's important to be clear about what positive psychology is and what it isn't. Positive psychology looks at what makes life worth living. It takes into account the role of positive emotions. It explores the building blocks of confidence and self-esteem, as well as what motivates us and our potential and our overall well-being. Although it differs from the more traditional view of psychology, which was largely focused on dealing with disorders and suffering, it doesn't ignore the fact that life has its challenges. So as a result, we see the learnings from positive psychology applied in sectors such as education and organisational development, as well as various disciplines that improve our personal effectiveness. So in summary, rather than measuring our success by how we compare to others, better to think more about how we compare to who we were yesterday. This means being fully aware and experiencing our range of positive emotions. It means being absorbed and engaged in what we're doing. It means developing strong connections and finding meaning in what we do and accomplishing what we set out to achieve. If we focus our attention on this more rounded approach, then the likelihood of happiness or contentment increases greatly. And we need to remember that happiness is not something on the horizon, it's something that we address now. That's all for this latest video. If you've enjoyed it, give it a like and feel free to leave a comment, as we'd love to hear from you. Do remember to press that subscribe button so you're alerted to new content. In the meantime, enjoy the journey.